All right, this next upcoming match is the 112-pound B weight class championships.
Here we go, Punahou and Roosevelt.
Looking for head position and hand fighting here. Roosevelt looking for a knee pick. Nothing happening there.
Fighting hands well. Nice shot by Punahou. Couldn't quite get in.
Roosevelt coming up with that underhook, looking for a hip toss. Got Punahou in trouble. Horsed her over. Got her on her back. Looking to secure some sort of hold. Can't find anything. Punahou fought back to her stomach. But not before she gave up three near fall. Right up to her feet. Or neutral again. Scores 5-1 Roosevelt. Walk you guys through what just happened there. Roosevelt secured a takedown for 2 points. Put Punahou on her back for 3 points, holding her there for a 3-point near fall, and then Punahou immediately escaped to score 1 point, making this score 5-1 now. Punahou's in on a shot now, got her ankle caught.
How deep on his hips.
Looking to cut across for a double,
she
and she finds
bounds.
It. Keeping both of her feet in bounds to catch that takedown. Making the score now 5-3. Roosevelt still in the lead, Punahou on top. Roosevelt straight up to her feet. Punahou stuck in this rear standing position. Roosevelt with the switch, looking to come back around. Punahou quickly re-switching to keep control of her top position. Roosevelt right up to her feet. Lots of action happening in this first period here. Roosevelt finds an escape. Looking to capitalize here and find a takedown. As Punahou dove in on a little bit of an outside shot there.
It's the end of the first period.
Wow, what an exciting first period.
There's a lot of action there.
So now we got the brackets here for the B weight classes, and this matchup right now is Kristen Pang from Punahou against Macy Higa from Roosevelt. Both of them pinned their way through their competition this tournament. I take that back. Kristen Pang had one major decision with two falls to find herself in the finals here now. Well, Macy Higa did have pins, three pins, to find herself in the finals now.
So we started the second period with Punahou on bottom. She chose bottom after Roosevelt had deferred to her. And Roosevelt's going for a cross
face. Has a cross face. Looks like she's got Punahou in trouble again.
She's racking up the near fall.
Getting some near fall. Punahou finds her way back to her stomach. Not without giving up 3 points for that back exposure, though.
Yeah. One for the escape there. Back to neutral.
Scores 4-9, Roosevelt currently. With a minute left in the second period. As I say that, Roosevelt finds another takedown, putting Punahou straight to her back. Finding more near fall.
Wrestling for third place.
This has really been an exciting match. Yeah. Wow, Roosevelt looking for a banana split. Nothing happened. Gave up a reversal.
On the way back up.
Now Pang's on top with wrist control.
See if she can return
in the rear standing.
The
she's getting dinged for stalling because she didn't bring Roosevelt back down to the mat quickly enough.
Roosevelt's trying to stand up again. Oh, and another reversal.
A little Peterson roll of sorts from
gone wrong.
From Higa.
10 seconds left in the second period. Let's see what happens here.
Puno has to stay off her back if she wants to make it through.
Really
she found her way back to her stomach. All right.
So some
points have to be put on the board here.
Wow.
And that looks like it brings the score to 19-6, Roosevelt.
So that's a
Macy Higa now has a commanding lead in the third, going into the third period here in this very exciting match that we have happening here at 112 pounds in the B bracket of the Pa'ani Challenge.
So if Higa scores two more points here, she'll find herself at a tech fall, which is 15 points more than her opponent.
And they stop the match then, because now it is technically as good as a fall. Technically as good as pinning your opponent, beating them by 15 points.
It doesn't score you as many points in a team competition.
But it's technically as good. Roosevelt looking to find her escape, and
that's
she does.
One point.
Making it 20-6, and found a quick takedown, 22-6. And I believe that
ball.
Should be it.
An aggressive match wrestled by both girls.
Very exciting match. Lots of attacking. That's what we like
it's
to
good,
see here.
Yeah.
And that's Macy Higa, our 112-pound B bracket champion of the Pioneer Challenge 2014. Congratulations, Macy.
Hi, I'm here with Macy, who is the first place winner of the B division in the 112 weight class. How does this win feel?
It feels good. This is like my first year wrestling, so I wasn't expecting all of this yet.
Oh, that's great. How did you prepare to come into this match?
I just tried to warm up thoroughly and not overthink it. Mm-hmm. Just kind of go, yeah.
How do you think you actually performed while in there?
I think I did better than I usually do just because I was able to score that many points. Most of the time I get stuck on the bottom, so I feel better about how I did this time.
Yeah, that was good. You built quite a substantial lead by the end. How do you feel going into the season now? Does this give you a confidence boost?
It helps a lot just on how I perform. I think I might do better just that I know that I can perform and do this well, so it might help my confidence when we do more.
All right, great. Congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
Thank you.